Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today I have a very, very interesting topic for you. This is a poem by Ka'b ibn Abi Sulma. This man has a very interesting story with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I would like to say the story quickly before I go with the poem that I have today. The story is that this man, he's a poet and is a very famous one in the ignorance time. Ignorance time is the era before Islam. He used to say a lot of poetry against the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and against the Muslims. He will curse them. He will say that they are cowards and stuff like that. So when the time of came that the Muslims took over Mecca, the city where this man lives, and where is the biggest army against Islam was there. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he got the news that this man was till the last moment telling poetry against the Muslim, cursing them. So he said, when you catch this man, bring him to me. And the man understood that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam wanted to kill him, so he ran away. But his brother was a Muslim, so his brother tried to come to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ask him to forgive him and to allow him to come and meet him. So he tried his best, and he sent to his brother a letter telling him, come to the Prophet and you will be safe once you meet him. But in his journey to the Prophet, he was so scared that any Muslim might meet him and misunderstand the words of the Prophet and will kill him. So he was hiding himself, traveling from at the night time, until he managed to come to the Prophet while he's covering, you know, his face. And then he put his hand in the hand of the Prophet and he told him his name. And then he started to say the poem. He said, he started like the ignorant Arabs, ignorant era Arabs, like the era before Islam, his poem by describing his beloved woman. They used to describe their beloved women, his wife or an imaginary woman that he loves. And then they could describe also camels, because he loved the camels so much. This is the only, like, the main means of transportation. Like nowadays, when somebody is describing his car, the best brand or the best car. And then he came to his apology and praising the Prophet and the companions. By the way, Ka'b ibn Zuhair ibn Abi Sulma, Ka'b ibn Zuhair ibn Abi Sulma became a Muslim after that time, since this story. And he lived in Islam a long time, as he lived in the time before Islam. And he started to say also poetry in Islam, praising Muslims and Islam. But this one was the most famous one for him. And it is called Al-Burdah. Al-Burdah is when somebody has like a nice coat. The Prophet ﷺ has a good coat at the time. So once Sa'd is finished, Ka'b is finished with a poem, this poet, he threw it over him and he gave it to him as a gift. He kept it with him till he died, and he was so proud of it. And then hence this poem is called Al-Burdah, Burdah al-Madih, the Burdah of praising the Prophet ﷺ. It became very, very famous in the Islamic world. Since this time until our modern time, until the end of the earth, Muslims keep chanting this poetry that, you know, praise the Prophet and praise the Muslims, say good things about them. So this was like a very necessary introduction before we go with the one. I tried my best to give you a translation of maybe half of the poem. I skipped the description of the woman, and I skipped the description of his the area where he lives, and then I came to the poem itself. I hope you enjoy the Arabic one and the English translation, that I will try to go line by line. And thank you, and I hope that you are going to learn from it, and you're going to see what it meant for the Muslims. Let's start the Arabic one.
وقال كل خليل كنت آمله لا ألهينك إني عنك مسؤول فقلت خلوا سبيلي لا أبا لكم فكل ما الرحمن مفعول كل ابن أنثى وإن طالت سلامته يوما على آلة حباء محمول أنبئت أن رسول الله أوعدني والعفو عند رسول الله مأمول وقد أتيت رسول الله معتذرا والعذر عند رسول الله مقبول مهلا هداك الذي أعطاك نافلة القرآن فيها مواعظ وتفصيل لا تأخذني بأقوال المشاة ولم أذنب وقد كثرت في الأقاويل لقد أقوم مقاما لو يقوم به أرى وأسمع ما لو يسمع الفيل لظل يرعد إلا أن يكون له من الرسول بإذن الله تنويل حتى وضعت يميني لا أنازعه في كف ذي نقمات قيله القيل لذاك أهيب عندي إذ أكلمه وقيل إنك منسوب ومسؤول من خادم من بيوت الأسد مسكنه من بطن عثر غيل دونه غيل يغدو فيلحم ضرغامين يعيشهما لحم من القوم معفور خراديل إذا يساور قرنا لا يحل له أن يترك القرن إلا وهو مغلول منه تظل سباع الجو ضامزة ولا تمشى بواديه الأراجيل ولا يزال بواديه أقوثقة مطرح البز والدرسان مأكول إن الرسول لسيف يستضاء به مهند من سيوف الله مسلول في فتية من قريش قال قائلهم ببطن مكة لما أسلموا زولوا زالوا فما زال أنكاس ولا كفف عند اللقاء ولا ميل معازيل شم العرانين أبطال له سمو من نسل داود في الهيجا سرابيل بيض سوابغ قد فكت لها حلق كأنها حلق القطع مجدول يمشون مشيا الجمال الزهر يعصمون ضر إذا عرض السود التنابيل لا يفرحون إذا نالت رماحهم قوما وليسوا مجازيعا إذا نيلوا لا يقع الطعن إلا في نحورهم وما لهم عن فياض الموت تهليل.
That's the end of the poem. Thank you for listening. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Trying to end the video. Sorry for that.